Welcome back to my second channel, where I just post kind of whatever I want, or at least until I figure out what my main idea is for this channel, other than just skateboarding, which is, you know, on my main channel. So I'll be putting skating on that, but then my more creative stuff on this. And one of those, I guess, the things that I like, number one, are books. If you were to tell 8 to 13 year old me that I would fall in love with reading and books, I wouldn't believe you. I would not believe you one bit. It took me a while to really enjoy books, you know, for numerous reasons. For number one, for me, reading always felt more like an obligation than for it to be something fun. Which is kind of weird in a way, because in a way, it's really up to me if I want to read or not. But then when you go to school, and you have to do assignments, and read a book, and write a paper about that book, you know, the work doesn't become as fun, unless you're like really passionate about reading and you actually get a kick out of writing a paper about your favorite book. If that's the case, then good for you. I mean, hey, do what makes you happy, I won't judge. But for me, it was a little bit different, and basically I'm gonna go into how I fell in love with reading and show you guys my book collection. And I'm not going to list through every single story or every single thing with this book, because I already tried that twice now, and it took like, I think it was like 25 minutes, and I had to save storage on my laptop and other shit like that. So yeah, I'm gonna show you guys my book collection, explain how I fell in love with reading, and just show different books from different series, and yeah, just do that. How I was able to finally fall in love with reading. It's a pretty simple explanation, and I'm sure I already knew this before I even started truly reading a little bit more, but for me to just, I guess, really get into it more, if not just a little bit more, I just had to find things that I really like and just read a lot of that. It's pretty simple for me, at least, you know? All the things that I like to read, I would say fiction, specifically historical fiction sometimes, science fiction. I'm surprisingly into war sometimes, not like real life wars, maybe war in like fictional stories, but I guess it kind of falls into the category of fiction, but that, I mean, hey, it's war, it's, you know, conflict, it's war. I think I'm also into romance, definitely romance. I don't know why, you know, I like romance. It's cool, it's nice, it's adorable. I almost forgot this, and for number 6, I would have to say mental health and well-being books. Those are all the subjects, or I guess all of the genres that I'm really into, so I guess now you guys know that. I guess I'll just go into these one by one. Catcher in the Rye by J.D. Salinger. It goes into certain topics, like suicide and also depression, and I think it also talks about certain, I think also other subjects it talks about is maybe self-harm as well. It's not 100%, like, it's more of like a fictional story, but I mean, in a way, it was basically supposed to spread a message about mental health and trying to, you know, like basically help people, you know, who have a hard time mentally. Because, you know, physical health is good too, but mental health is also very important as well. And I feel like currently now, or maybe just anytime in general, you know, mental health is a serious subject now more than ever. And I don't really touch on mental health that much, but I've been watching the news. I don't really like watching the news, but I've seen some things out there, and I think there really are some people that could honestly need someone to talk to, or maybe someone that needs some help mentally, and I think it's good to spread this message, even though this book was made back in like the 40s or like the 50s, so it's like decades old. But back then, I mean, mental health wasn't really much of a thing, you know? You had to be all tough and, you know, and strong, and like hide your feelings maybe, even though I wasn't really there, but I mean, that's what I've heard. So, yeah, mental health and well-being, yeah, very important. Next over here is The Universe Has Your Back by Gabrielle Bernstein, which is right over here. Talks about letting go and trying to turn your fear into faith and basically giving up your fear, giving into love, and stuff like that. It kind of changed my perspective on fear, which I think has helped me somewhat handle it a little bit better, but I'm still in the works on that, so I can't really say I've 100% gotten anywhere yet. But it's still interesting to read, and it's changed my perspective, so I like it. Next is The Magic of Thinking Big by David J. Schwartz, PhD. And this book is honestly really nice, you know? It talks about success, about trying to better oneself, I think maybe mentally, and also trying to change your perspective so that way you could be on a clear goal, or a clear or a clear pathway to success. So I really do like it. I think there are some certain things here when it comes to maybe fear or overthinking or maybe just other parts of life that I can honestly find this book really useful for. And I really feel like this could be good for my well-being and my mental health in general. So basically, I'm gonna go over some light novels and some manga. Number one, anime of the year, I think between 2019 or 2021. I honestly forgot I might leave the year when I edit this video, so here it is. Jujutsu Kaisen. Love this. Really good anime, really good story. I really like how sometimes the story can be kind of dark, but then it can also be really funny at like the exact same time. I swear, Gigi Akutami, I really hope I pronounced her name right. If not, I'm gonna feel bad. But really good story, you know? And I'm honestly probably gonna buy more manga for this in the future, so cool. Next, this series. This, I think, actually got a few awards this year in 2022, I believe. If not, maybe in 2021, but it's honestly a really, really good franchise, or at least for me, it just has a really good story. And this is from another anime, which also has light novels and manga for it. And it's my favorite number now, 86 by Asato Asato. And the artwork in this, or at least for the manga, by Motoki Yoshihara. I can't touch on this too much. It's basically fighting a war against this robot army, a bunch of people being forced to do it against their will, a lot of discrimination between certain types of people and their races, and just trying to survive and hope to live to see a better future and try to live beyond the battlefield in a way. That's basically how much I can really summarize it, but I got these two books for Christmas. These are the manga, and yeah, these are really great. The artwork is absolutely amazing in manga, bro, I swear to God. Literally, I could just, like, watch an anime and, like, read the manga for it, and even though, like, I already know what's going to happen when I read the book, it's just still fun to see, like, certain differences between the anime and the books, and just to see how it's differently adapted for each one, you know? Certain types of dialogue, what a person says, what another person says, it's just really interesting. I forgot to say that before, so I'm saying it now, but yeah, these are really good. Next are the light novels for 86. These are the ones with mainly text, but also a few pictures and some stuff in between. And I guess I'll just show these two. Typically for me, I can enjoy it honestly almost as much, if not just as much, as the manga for 86. So yeah, here we got volume 3, Run Through the Battlefront, Finish. Here we have volume 4, I believe this is called Under Pressure. And on the inside, I don't know why, but I think this might be my favorite book out of them all, because the pictures are just, like, they're spot on. Oh, if I could just fold this right without ripping the book, please. Bam, like, look at those pictures, man. You cannot go wrong with that. It's just beautiful. And then, especially this one. This one is honestly, like, I love this. This is just really, really wonderful. Like, they really do good with the art in the light novels too, man. Like, it's really hard for me to compare the art in manga to the art in light novels, because, like, they're both really good. So, yeah. That was volume 4, and then this one that I have yet to read, because I'm still reading the Jujutsu Kaisen manga for volume 2, volume 5, Death Be Not Proud. Yet again, really good art, and I'm looking forward to reading this one, because I have yet to read this, but I really enjoy reading these. It's very, very, like, interesting, and it's just, yeah, I love this. I'm kind of crazy for this anime. Maybe a little bit too much, but honestly, I don't really think it's too much. I respect the story and the artwork and all the time that's put into it, and I'm gonna look back at this, and this is gonna be definitely one of my favorite animes, and definitely in my top 10. So yeah, 86, amazing. Here we have the Chaos Walking series. This is The Knife of Never Letting Go. This is the first book. Here is The Ask and the Answer, and here is Monsters of Men, and I also forgot to mention the author, Patrick Ness. So yeah, this is the first book right here, this is the sequel, and then this is the book that makes it a trilogy. This. So, yeah. I really love these books. I mean, if I love them so much, I might just maybe read them over again, or maybe just buy more books by the same authors, or maybe just more books like in the series. But yeah, I really enjoy all these books. I love them a lot, and yeah, they mean a lot to me. All I need now is a bookshelf because we're taking a little bit too much space on my desk. But yeah, I was going to go more into depth on each and every book, but honestly, it's way too long and way too hard to explain, or it's not really too hard to explain, but I feel like if I were to go and explain the story more in depth for each and every one of these franchises or just these books in general, it would take a while, so I had to shorten this a little bit. So maybe this will be maybe 15 minutes instead, maybe 16, 17 at most. Maybe I'll just make a video for each and every one of these books, or maybe just each and every one depending on their topic, or maybe the way that I want to do them, and I'll just explain them maybe one by one, or maybe together in a group, and just show you guys why I love them so much and how it really has changed my perspective or impacted me as a human being. And yeah, I'm done. I'm glad I finally finished making this video. Editing it, I think I'm gonna enjoy editing it. Because I feel like me trying to make like other videos that I love just makes it all the more worthwhile. And yeah, maybe I'll make more videos like these in the future. Maybe I won't, but I figured that this is my second channel. I might as well try and upload something. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know what you think of this. And I'm going to chill. I'm going to enjoy life. And I encourage you guys to do the same. Peace out.